2 on AM 950 KPRC, 50 plus on this Thursday afternoon. Thanks to you all for listening today. We'll shift to a medical gear in this segment, a spinoff of sorts from this past week's discussion of summer heat and the things it can do to us. The source of that heat, of course, is the sun, and sunlight presents its own dangers to our skin. To explain, I'll bring in Dr. Adam Scheiner, a cosmetic surgeon whose patients routinely ask for help with sun-damaged skin. Welcome aboard, Doc.
Well, thank you so much, Doug. Nice talking to you.
Yeah, my pleasure, too. My generation had no idea the long-term damage we were doing to our skin back when we were putting on baby oil with a touch of iodine in it and things like that. Is all of that bad stuff manifesting itself now in a rise in skin cancers?
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. Well, I'll explain this a little bit if you got a minute. Okay.
Sure.
So, you know, when the sun shines down on the earth, it's comprised of multiple wavelengths of light. Some are visible and allow us to see one another. Others are invisible. The most important amongst these are the ultraviolet or UV wavelengths of light. They include UVC, UVB, and UVA. UVC is primarily absorbed by the ozone. That's UVC. UVB is a wavelength that makes our skin red. B for burn. Mm-hmm. Most probably from about 10 to 4 p.m. And UVA is a long wavelength that can penetrate deep in the skin where it fractures elastic and collagen fibers, allowing our skin to sag and droop. A for aging. It's present all day long, can even penetrate clouds and car windows. These UV rays combine together parts of our DNA in the basal cell layer of epidermis, which is a part of the top layer of our skin, where it creates something called thiamine dimers and makes the cells irregular, leading to basal cell and squamous cell cancers. What you were kind of mentioning is in the 70s and 80s, sunscreens came around and allowed us to stay out in the sun longer without getting red because it blocked the UVB rays, the B for burn.
Okay.
But we saw skin cancer rise, and this is because it was blocking just one of those dangerous rays. It was blocking UVB, so it was getting red, so we could stay out longer. But we didn't realize we were getting twice the dose of UVA unimpeded. Boy. Recently, we have ways to protect against UVB and UVA using titanium dioxide and zinc oxide, which are mechanical blocks that work immediately when they're placed on the skin.
How much of that, like a zinc oxide, for example, do you just have to paint yourself in it, or are some of the products that have it kind of where you can not see it and you don't look like Casper the Ghost? Okay.
Yeah, they're micronized now, so they blend in pretty easily with the skin.
Oh,
yeah.
Good. And this is, we're talking about cumulative damage here, right? Like wearing the tread off your tires, only we just can't go down to the skin store and replace the damaged skin, right?
Well, there are ways that we can do this. But yes, without intervention, you're kind of stuck with what you have.
Okay. Well, let's talk about awareness and self-examination first. What are we looking for that is going to warrant a trip to the dermatologist?
Sure. You know, there are flaky skins that can, skin lesions that can form on the face, the chest, and they're called actinic keratoses. 10% of those go on to form squamous cell carcinomas. Mm. Then you have the lesions which have rolled pearly edges, and those are suspicious for things called basal cell carcinomas. And then melanomas are the more scary one. Those are the ones that can actually be lethal. They're often, interestingly, in non-sun-exposed areas. Things to look out for are asymmetry of a pigmented lesion, an irregular border on a lesion, differing colors in the lesion, and something where the diameter is greater than a quarter inch in diameter.
Okay. So we're looking for a pretty big thing. If we see something little, I made a note here. Is it a good idea maybe to just take a picture of it with a little measuring device next to it and then look at it again in a couple of weeks or a month or two?
Yeah, probably like 6 months or so, too. Or, you know, in today's digital realm, if you have a dermatologist, you can send it to them.
I don't know if mine wants me to just be sending him pictures without me coming in there. We'll see. I know him pretty well. He might do that. I believe he and I went to the same high school, as a matter of fact. So if we do notice something very small, Dr. Adam Scheiner on 50 Plus, if we notice something very small, we don't have to immediately panic and rush to the doctor's office. We just monitor.
Yeah. If it's small, that's the issue. But if it's one of those pigmented ones I was talking about, they're changing. Yeah. Those you would want to see someone a little bit sooner.
Yeah, different colors, irregular borders. I've had these discussions before over the years, and those are the two things that I remember correctly. Now, are all of these dangerous things that we're looking for going to be raised, or can they be flat as well?
They're usually raised most of the time.
Okay.
Some can be a little flat, but most of them raised to a certain degree.
Fair enough. Pretty good prognosis if they're caught early too, right?
Absolutely true. Yep.
And how
they
do
can
you
be caught early and dealt with?
Yeah. How do we deal with those? How do you deal with those?
So, you know, there are three different things that are out there to help with removing sun damage. One is something known as Retin-A or tretinoin. It's a medical product that was discovered by Albert Kligman, who's a professor in the Department of Dermatology at the University of Pennsylvania. That's where I went to medical school. And Retin-A can actually fix some of these thiamine dimers I was talking about.
Okay.
There's something called BBL, broad-based light, by a company called Cyton, and they this thing where they can get rid of spots on the face or the body, red spots, brown spots. They thought they were just doing that, but then they did research on it and found that it caused the skin to revert back to a younger genetic state.
Oh, wow.
That doesn't really have any downtime with it. And then my reset for sun damage is really amazing. It's a little bigger procedure, but I can get rid of a whole lifetime of sun damage in patients and get rid of a lot of cancers that way as well.
Where do I have to fly to find you?
I'm in Tampa, Florida.
Okay, well, that's not a bad place to be. Dude, you're right at ground zero for sun exposure. Holy cow. Yeah, that's
yeah, well, now we have the possible Stanley Cup winners coming again. We'll see.
Oh, yeah, we'll see about that. What? how about you got laser? You got all these different things. How many people know about this type of procedure and are taking advantage of it?
Well, I have a lot of people that come. So what the lasers do is, you know, most of the damage from the ultraviolet rays are to the top layer of our skin, the epidermis. Mm-hmm. That's where that basal cell layer lives, and that's where basal cell carcinomas come from. So when I use a laser to treat the skin, I remove the top layer, including the basal cell layer, and all the damage above it. When the body regrows the skin, new cells come back to fill that area that have never seen the sun before. It improves the appearance of the skin with tighter skin, new collagen, elastic fibers, and the health of the skin as it removes precancers and some active cancers as well. That's why I call it a reset for sun damage.
That's pretty nice. That really is. I like that idea. If somebody is aware of their skin, if somebody is like I'm doing, going to my dermatologist once a year, what are the odds that we might end up being killed by skin cancer?
That's a good question. Not likely. I mean, these things are not growing overnight. But during the year, if you found something that was changing, a lesion that was changing, that's maybe within the year you might want to see your dermatologist.
You know, I'm kind of an old goat myself. And it was probably about a month ago now, or about 3 weeks ago, I looked down on my right forearm and there was a spot as big as a dime that looked like just red and ugly and irritated. And I thought, holy cow, where'd this come from? And then I started thinking, okay, it's not raised and it's not something that looks like anything I'd be scared of. So I did take a picture of it, and in 3 weeks now, it's pretty much gone. I think it was just a bruise from picking up my golf bag wrong.
There you go.
Like, that was a close call because it was big and ugly, I got to tell you. So what, Dr. Scheiner, what is kind of the bottom line for my audience? The audience is 50 plus, let's say, 50, 60. We want to get out in the sun. We still want to enjoy ourselves, but we got to stay safe. Clothing and sunscreen and shade, is that what we're looking for?
Yeah, the best thing is really these mechanical blocks, titanium dioxide and zinc oxide. Mm-hmm. They work immediately. You know, now they're worried about, you know, in Hawaii, they will not allow any sun blocks that aren't mechanical blocks like this that reflect the sun directly. Some of the other ones that are actually ones that absorbed in the skin. Anyway, those are not safe for the reefs, you know, the reefs in the ocean.
Oh,
so they're
okay.
Mandating now in Hawaii that all sun blocks have to be mechanical blocks when you visit, you know, Hawaii.
I remember beyond reading that, something. You know, go ahead.
Yeah. Beyond that, watching the hours that you're out. So if you want to golf maybe earlier in the day or later in the day, you know, or boat earlier in the day or later in the day. Wearing hats is great. Sunglasses, there's damage that can happen to the eye, too. With sun exposure, you can have growths on the white part of the eye known as pinguecula that can turn into something called a pterygia that grows on the eye. So wearing sunglasses is important whenever you're outside. And then, yeah, there's really sun-safe clothing as well that can reflect the light, keep you cooler. They have vents in them, and that's good for, like, larger areas like your arms and things like that.
Dr. Adam Scheiner down in Tampa, thank you so very much. I really appreciate your time today, my friend.
It was wonderful talking to you, you know. And yes, I'd be happy to help you, Doug, or any of your patients in Houston. We have a lot of people flying to see
you. Do you have a website down there?
Yeah. If they look up my name, and you probably in your description there, but it's AdamScheinerMD.com, S-C-H-E-I-N-E-R. But if they look up Reset for Sun Damage, they'll find me.
Very good. Reset for Sun Damage. I like that. That's a great name. Well done, sir. All right. Thank you, Doc. I appreciate it.
Thanks.